to be doing a makeup tutorial for you, and can we please, please just stop and take a moment from my background? I'm sorry, I just need a minute. If you guys know me at all, you know I'm obsessed with glitter. I'm obsessed with wearing glitter, looking at glitter, whether it's in a dress, whether it's makeup. My whole entire house is decorated in like whites and silvers and accents of glitter. I love glitter, and I've wanted to have a glitter background since before I even started YouTube, but I just have kind of put it off because I felt like it was gonna be like too difficult or take away from like the personable aspect or just whatever it may be. Or like I felt like a lot of girls were doing a glitter background at one point. So I don't know, I've just put it off for a long time. But I found a bunch of different ones on Amazon and I was like, yes please, 2-day shipping. And so I thought I would give it a whirl. In a few minutes, you're gonna see this background's gonna disappear. I'm gonna be doing my makeup with my normal background. But honestly guys, let's just get real. This background is not as amazing as it seems. It's being held up by two lamps and it's about to fall on me at any second. Just letting you know. But let me know how you feel about this glitter background. If you just like it in the intros, if maybe you would like an entire video with a glitter background every once in a while, let me know, because I am very big and like obsessed with my backgrounds, and I want it to be aesthetically pleasing and I want it to be something that you guys enjoy looking at. So I always like hearing your opinions on my background. So let me know how you feel, but please do not hate on the glitter because that would really hurt me. Last night I destroyed my thumb. I'm not gonna get into it because it's absolutely disgusting, but long story short, I picked up a huge serrated knife to open up a UPS box, and instead of going to the box, it went right to my thumb and just, oh my God, it was so disgusting. So today's makeup tutorial was definitely a challenge for me, not being able to use this damn thumb because it hurts so bad. And let me just say, applying lashes was a whole new level of difficult not being able to use this bad boy. So if you're wondering what this ugly bandage is, that is the current situation at hand. No pun intended. Today's makeup tutorial is actually the exact same look that I wore in my Best of Beauty video back in January. I know that's so random, but when I posted a picture on Instagram, it was like the most requested tutorial I've ever seen from you guys. And you have continuously requested this video on a daily basis. So of course I had to do it. And I hope that you guys enjoy. I absolutely love this look so much. I hope that you love it as much as me. If you do, give it a big thumbs up. All right, I love you guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoy, and I'll see you soon. Bye, guys.
Well, hello, my loves. I have missed you. So the first thing we are going to do today is prime our skin. I am using the Smashbox Primer Water. I'm over half done with this bottle. I love it so much. And then I'm going to go in with a second primer. That's right. This is the Makeup Forever Primer, and this is the smoothing one. I do have all of them, and I'm trying them out one at a time. This smoothing one really, really smoothed out my pores, filled everything in, but it also made me very matte. I personally am not crazy about being matte, but I would definitely recommend it to those of you who want that matte look, because my oh my, this made it happen. Then I'm going to go in with the Dior Nude Air Serum Foundation, and I'm going to mix it with the Kevin Aucoin Liquid Highlighter. Oh my gosh, you guys. These two are a match made in heaven. I will go more in depth about them soon, but I absolutely love these two. So I just kind of make a little cocktail on the back of my hand of both of these, and then I'm going to just stipple it on my face using a Sigma F80 flat top kabuki brush, and I'm going to just press that into the skin. What I love about this Dior foundation is it truly looks like skin, and this highlighter is so beautiful. It gives such a natural radiant glow like you can see right here. I just love them together. Then I'm going to conceal my under eye area using the Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer. I have been using this almost all month and I've really been enjoying it. More than anything, I love the applicator. Like, I just love this little like flimsy wand that it has. It makes it so easy to apply. So using a damp beauty blender, I'm going to just press this into the skin and blend it outward. Then I'm going to set that entire under eye area using my under eye setting powders. Same thing as always. I'm using a Sigma tapered highlighting brush to do so on the entire under eye area. And I also set the lid. That way my eyeshadow is going to go on a little bit more smoothly. So now we get to move on to the eye area. First shadow I'm going to take is Peach Smoothie by Makeup Geek, and I'm going to apply that with a Sigma E40. This is not a must for everyone, but it is just a must for me. I pretty much use Peach Smoothie in the beginning of every single eye look because it's just ideal for my skin tone. Then I'm going to go in with the Jaclyn Hill Favorites palette by Morphe, and I'm going to take this kind of very light medium brown transition color, we're going to call it. It doesn't have a name, so that's my name for it. Going in with the exact same E40 brush, I'm going to just dust that back and forth in windshield wiper motions, and then I'm going to kind of blend upward and outward with this brush so we have no harsh lines. Then I'm going to mix these two colors together, this very dark chocolatey brown and then this kind of almost like a raspberry purpley brown. And I'm going to take an E25 from Sigma and I'm going to start packing that in the outer corner of my lid and then blending that out. You can put this all over your lid if you want. It doesn't matter because for this look, we are going to go in and cover up the majority of the lid area. So you can be kind of sloppy and kind of messy with this and work it kind of all over the place. But the key to blending is always going back with a bigger, fluffier brush like I am right now with that E40 and then continuously going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth with those two brushes, the bigger one and then the more small, dense one that will really make sure that nothing is harsh. Then going in with a definer brush, I'm going to just pack that brown on the lower lash line. You don't have to put this down there. You can put all purple down there, but I go in with this first, and then I am going to go in with Anastasia Iridescent Purple, and I'm going to pack that very intensely on the outer corner of the lower lash line because I really want a purple down there just for some funness. But you could use the purples from the Jaclyn Hill Favorites palette, but I just wanted to use that one, so it's happening. Now I'm going in with the Makeup Forever Shadow in D-552, and I did wet in my brush a little bit with some MAC Fix Plus. If you don't own that, you can use eye drops. It'll pretty much work the same. Using a MAC 242 brush, I'm going to just pack that silver color all over the lid. Once we get to the outer portion of the lid, I'm going to kind of stamp like you see right now. I have to wait for it to dry, so I'm doing a quick little dance, and then once that Fix Plus has dried, I'm just going to go in with that same Sigma brush and kind of blend out the edges because I don't want it to be too harsh or like jaggedy. Then I'm going to go in with a MAC Pro. This is High Def Scion. This is a very, very intense blue eyeliner. It's available online and at MAC Pro stores, but it's not available at like regular MAC stores. You can use any blue, but that's what I wanted to use. I had a very difficult time with my contour today. I don't know why. Everything was coming out very muddy and very dirty, so I'm kind of rushing through this process, but I am using the Kat Von D Contour Kit to do this, and I did use that really intense yellow color just to kind of highlight everything because I thought, hey, if the contour isn't working that great, we're just gonna highlight away and just fake it till we make it. Now I'm gonna go in and just coat my lashes with mascara because we know that we're gonna pop on some falsies and get ready for it. Just get ready. No thumb, no thumb. Yes. Go girl, go girl. No thumb, no thumb. Most difficult moment of my life. I mean, not really first world problems, but it was a little difficult. So now that we have our lashes on, I am going to go in with Makeup Geek blushes and I'm going to mix Spellbound and Head Over Heels. These are my two favorite blushes to mix together for a nice pink cheek. And I wanted to do something pink instead of coral because I always do coral and I've been loving pink recently. So that's what I did. Taking the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Palette, I'm going to use the middle shade, and I'm also going to be using the Morphe M501 brush to highlight the tops of the cheekbones, and I will also bring this on the center and the apple of the cheek just for an extra pop of highlight and glow. I'm going to coat my lower lashes with mascara. As always, I can't do a makeup look without doing my lower lashes, I feel. And then to finish this look off, I'm going to use the ColourPop Lippy Stick in the shade Cake. Absolutely love this color. It's like a bright corally pink. It's just so beautiful for spring. Finish everything off with Urban Decay Chill Makeup Setting Spray. Give yourself a quick bath in this, fan yourself off, and we are good to go. So it's pretty easy. I hope that you guys enjoy. Thank you so much for watching. I love you guys, and I'll see you soon. Bye. Say hi to the people!
Hello! Hi, hello!
Yes, this is on fleek!
Glamour!
Glamour!
Oh, it's actually really good.
Oh, can you see it?
Yeah.
Yes, bitch! This is what I'm talking about! That's the jankiest thing I've ever seen. We need to get thinking around here. What can hold this up as my background? You can't think, you look miserable.
Well then, what, I mean, do you have any other ideas?
Just drop it. Now my background is so basic. It was so much better when that was up. Are you trying to give me a wedgie?
I'm trying to make your crack not show.
Oh. Because the camera can really see that. What? Ow! I'm sorry, but this background is too glamorous. And this bitch cost me $4.99.
Where'd you get it?
Amazon Prime. Give me some. Give me some.